This video provides a very brief overview of hemostasis. There are three processes involved in hemostasis. These are vascular spasm, platelet plug formation, and blood clotting. Vascular spasm is caused when arteries and arterioles are damaged. Specifically, it is when the smooth muscle, which circles around the walls of these vessels, is damaged. This causes them to contract immediately. This can reduce the blood loss for several minutes to several hours and allows time for the other hemostatic mechanisms to operate. Platelet plug formation is the next stage. Platelets, although small, contain many chemicals including clotting factors, enzymes and hormones. Platelets will stick to the collagen and connective tissue which has been exposed by the damage to the blood vessels. This is known as platelet adhesion. Platelet adhesion causes the platelets to become activated and their characteristics change dramatically. They extend many projections on their surface which enable them to make contact with other platelets and they start to release their content into the local area. In particular, they release thromboxane A2, which activates other nearby platelets and causes further vasoconstriction. And they also release ADP, adenosine diphosphate, which makes the platelets sticky. This is known as the platelet release reaction. Interesting, in this process, they also release something called prostacycline. And this stops platelets sticking to healthy, intact vessel walls and contains the area of blood clotting. Why do you think this is? The sticky platelets stick to each other and this is known as platelet aggregation. And the consequential mass of platelets is known as the platelet plug. So these are all the stages in the platelet plug formation. The next stage in hemostasis, as we've said, is blood clotting. Blood clotting occurs once the blood leaves the blood vessels. It will thicken and form a gel. Eventually, the gel separates from the liquid serum, which is plasma without the clotting proteins. The gel is a clot which contains insoluble protein fibres known as fibrin, and trapped within these fibres are the formed elements of blood. Clotting requires several substances known as clotting factors, and these include calcium and inactivated enzymes which are identified by their Roman numerals 1 to 13. Blood clotting can be divided up into three pathways. We call these the clotting cascade. The first stage within this clotting cascade is known as the extrinsic pathway. The extrinsic pathway occurs within seconds of damage to the cells, and it occurs in tissues outside of the blood vessels, hence the word extrinsic, outside of. Thromboplastin, which is a type of tissue factor, leaks into the blood from the damaged cells. In the presence of calcium, thromboplastin activates clotting factor 10. In turn, clotting factor 10 and clotting factor 5 make prothrombinase. The next stage in the clotting cascade is the intrinsic pathway. This is a more complex pathway than the extrinsic pathway and occurs more slowly over several minutes. activators are in direct contact with the blood or contained within the blood vessel, hence intrinsic or inside of. Activated platelets release phospholipids. In the presence of calcium, clotting factor 12 is activated, and this activates clotting factor 10. Clotting factor 10 and clotting factor 5 make prothrombinase. So as you can see, both the extrinsic and the intrinsic pathway result in the production of prothrombinase. And from here, the clotting cascade follows the common pathway. In the presence of calcium, prothrombinase, which is the result of the extrinsic and the intrinsic pathway, converts prothrombin, or clotting factor 2, into thrombin. Thrombin in turn converts soluble fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin, and it is these fibrin threads which form the threads of the blood clot. So all of these pathways together result in the production of fibrin. And it is fibrin which makes up blood clot. Thrombin also activates factor 13, which stabilises the fibrin threads and strengthens the clot. Clots are constantly being made and broken down by the fibrinolytic system in our body, and if the blood clots too easily, then a thrombosis may occur. If blood takes too long to clot, hemorrhage can occur. So the body has a fine balance of maintaining hemostasis.